Luis, Dr. Reyes, let me let you take the lead on this. Just the mechanics of testing. We've all sort of hinted at it. Some do it internally, some are sending it out. Can you give us a sense of how one can get in-track testing done?
We have several options, as somebody else mentioned, as it was Jyoti. For example, we can do RT-PCR. We can do RT-PCR to find these fusions. We can do FISH to find these fusions. We can do DNA sequencing. And lately, we're doing RNA sequencing. Mm. So now we have four options. How we deal with this? What is the best approach? Actually, it depends. Probably the best recommendations that we have, for example, they are written in ESMO has recommendations published last year about this, but these are common sense. For example, if this is a tumor that is very uncommon, lung cancer, colon cancer, breast cancer, they have a very low prevalence of NTRK fusions. The best thing that we can do is do the whole sequence, the whole DNA sequence. But we also have discovered in the last 3 or 4 years that we're doing that for NTRK, that the DNA sequence may not be as complete or comprehensive as the transcriptome sequencing, the RNA sequencing. So that's why we have now platforms or centers that they run both. We do the DNA sequencing, and then we do the RNA sequencing to catch any possibility or any fusion that has not been discovered. So that's for uncommon tumors. When you have one of these tumors that are very rich in NTRK, mammalian analog salivary cancer, secretory carcinoma, those the saliva, breast secretory cancers, congenital nephromas in kids or fibrosarcomas, you know that the incidence or the prevalence of NTRK is very high, maybe 90%. Yeah. So you can shoot straight. You can do RT-PCR, you can do FISH. For example, the salivary cancers are very high in NTRK3. So you can go straight and try to find that genetic aberration. So then that way, maybe you don't have to do a whole sequencing.
Yeah.
And the last option that we have, option number three, not very common, is the possibility, what we used to do before is, you know, we used to love FISH. We oncologists used to do FISH for breast cancer. Mm-hmm. When we started to do lung cancer, we learned about that. So we used to do maybe FISH is good for ALK. Then we discovered that maybe FISH is good for ROS. But it's too cumbersome. There are too many FISH now. You know, we have to do ALK, ROS, NTRK, and soon RET. So it doesn't work. That's why the developing of immunohistochemistry is a very good option, because the problem is the amount of use of the tissue, that there is not enough tissue for maybe use or look for other genetic aberrations. But some people have been successful publishing data that a pan antibody for NTRK can probably catch more than 90% of the genetic aberrations. Maybe that's an option for a center that don't have the technology for an RNA sequencing, you know?
Yeah, but I mean, what you just described is complicated. I can barely keep track of how to give FOLFOX.